Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God and in me.
Good evening, everyone. This is Tube87, and I'm back again for a second video today. This one is going to address the topic of leadership in the churches. People are constantly leaving churches because they don't appreciate the leadership that they have. They don't respect the leadership that they have. The leadership has issues, etc. There are all sorts of reasons why people are leaving the churches, but leadership is a big problem. Now, one thing to be known and understood is that the Word gives us some qualifications for those who are going to lead the church. And when this isn't happening in the church, maybe you shouldn't be there, because if you understand Scripture, if you know your Scripture, you study Scripture, people who lead are supposed to be a particular type person, character, have particular behaviors and all these things. And when this goes awry, it creates chaos in your church home. But anyway, I'm going to read some of what Scripture says about this, and it may answer some of the questions for some of you, because people question the leadership and stay in the churches. They don't like what's going on amongst the leaders, but they stay in the church anyway, or they ignore it, or are actually part of it. So I'm going to tell you what the Word says, and you can make your own choices. We have free will, remember. Anyway, with that, let's get started with leadership. Okay, we're going to start at 1 Timothy chapter 3 at the top. It reads, it says, "This is a true saying, if a man desire the office of a bishop, he desireth a good work." Verse 2, "A bishop then must be blameless, the husband of one wife, vigilant, sober, of good behavior, given to hospitality, apt to teach." Okay, well, let's stop right there and go back up to the top of verse 2. It says, "A bishop then must be blameless." Well, what does that mean? Well, if we go right over to Titus chapter 1, verses 6 through 10, it'll tell us. It reads, starting with verse 6, "If any be blameless, the husband of one wife, having faithful children, not accused of riot or unruly." Okay, already it brings in more factors to who you need to be as an individual wanting to be a bishop. It brings your household into it. You have to have your household in check. It says your children have to be faithful. Verse 7, "For a bishop must be blameless as the steward of God, not self-willed, not soon angry, not given to wine, no striker, not given to filthy lucre." Okay, filthy lucre, let's stop there for a second. Ill-gotten gains. You know, this is about individuals who are concerned about ill-gotten gains, getting rich and all these things. Verse 8, "Be a lover of hospitality, a lover of good men, sober, just, holy, temperate." Verse 9, "Holding fast the faithful word as he has been taught, that he may be able by sound doctrine both to exhort and to convince the gainsayers. For there are many unruly and vain talkers and deceivers, especially they of the circumcision." Okay, it speaks for itself. To be in these positions, you have to be a upright, righteous, and just person. You have to be of sound mind. You have to have your household in check. It says your children, they have to be faithful. Now, let's look at 2 Timothy 2:24, because it says, "Also, he must be apt to teach." 2 Timothy 2:24 reads, it says, "And the servant of the Lord must not strive, but be gentle unto all men, apt to teach, patient." So he has to have all these characteristics, these qualifications. You have to be a patient, loving, meek, humble, or you have to be a special person. You can't just jump into these positions and then live your life the way you want. You have to live your life according to the Heavenly Father's qualifications. This is why there are so many issues in the churches, because the congregation looks at their leadership and see and know, if they're not involved, some of them, what's going on behind the alleged closed doors, who's involved in what, and the church is full of chaos and drama. People are leaving, people are murmuring, people are complaining about what's going on in the church. They're questioning their leadership, and this is why they're not following the qualifications that the Father has in His Word that they're supposed to be following. They're not living according to the will of the Heavenly Father. So what is sound doctrine? Now turn with me to 2 Timothy 4 and verse 3. It reads, it says, "For the time will come, they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust they shall heap to themselves teachers having itchy ears." So these individuals who are in leadership positions who aren't doing what they're supposed to be doing, there is going to come a time, and we're told in chapter 3 verse 1, it says, "This also know, that in the last days perilous times shall come." That's the time that it's talking about. And when these times come, these individuals are not going to stand to sound doctrine because they're not doing it now. So if you're questioning the leadership in your church, if you see these things going on, if these leaders' households are in chaos, adulterers, liars, stealers, gossipers, all these things and plenty other, if their households aren't in order, if their wives are to be blameless as they are, the leadership qualifications carry through the individual into their household, their children and their wives also have to be in order. If these things aren't in order, the people in the church know it, and what happens? You don't respect their leadership. You have issues with the leadership. You leave the churches, or you complain and murmur and whatever else goes on. It's total chaos. So if your leaders aren't following the qualifications that the Father has set forth in the Word, then maybe you need to find a new leader. But first and foremost, study the Word for yourself. Teach yourself so you can spot things and know things right off, and you don't have to be dependent upon another man in the hope that he's not leading you astray, because you will have some accountability in your own self being led astray because you're not studying the Word on your own. But anyway, with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father doesn't call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful and be diligent and loving to one another. This is Tube 87. I'm out.